What is up, guys, and welcome to the Beyond Sanas channel. My name is Shanks, and today we are playing a 4v4 match on a beautiful map, Lamadon, in Battleform Middle Earth 1 on a patch 2.22. I pick random, and we get to play the Mordor faction. Okay, let's build an army worthy of Mordor, shall we? So Mordor, Gondor, Rohan combination. Our opponents have Rohan, Gondor, Mordor, and one time random. So I don't see any Isengard on the board, which is good for me because Mordor's biggest opponent, biggest enemy, is the Freezing Rain from Isengard. Remember, the Freezing Rain is able to shut down all our leadership bonuses for like 3 minutes straight, which is a nightmare for the Mordor players. And on this map, I mean, in 4v4 maps generally, you get much more money, and this way we should be in a perfectly fine spot.
Pay attention!
And also, in 4v4 maps, as Mordor, you don't need to build an Orc Pit. Why? Because you can just get to the power spike of getting a Troll Kitch upon the field much, much sooner this way. So, starting with double slaughterhouse, getting like 2-3 meals outside will grow us rich in literally no time. And, dude, I gotta admit, it's been a really long time since my last 4v4 match, and they are always so messy in Battleform Middle-Earth 1, you know what I'm saying? Because it's a leadership battle, boys. So the army with more leadership will always have a better standing. But remember, even though we have Mordor, you don't want to have more than one Mordor in your team. Because, you know, they are only supporters. So one Mordor faction is enough all alone to support all the three allies. But in this game, we won't be a supportive Mordor. No, 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 no. We will be building Mumakil army, guys. That's the plan. That's the plan. Because we know the opponent has at bare minimum one Rohan, and we can siege the Rohan castle with our Mumakil army.
You laborers, get to work. More laborers, eh? Put them to work.
Down, you maggots.
Actually, we can buy the outpost, dude. I didn't even know that the outpost has zero protection on it. So my ally is creeping. I was also using Eye to boost him. He will now deal, you know, be able to deal more damage and also level up much, much faster because of the additional combat experience of the Great Eye of Sauron. And what we can eventually do is we can buy the outpost and build like a Haradrim palace to put Haradrims inside the outpost to protect it against the opponent. And also the placement of this outpost is actually very good because we are in a spot in which we can block this kind of little... Oh, but there is a troll there. Dude, Alamadon, man. I think it's been like over 5 years at bare minimum since the last time I played on this map. So I need to relearn the map. But our money is looking good. Our ally is getting pressured. We are in a chicken spot. That means we should be in a good spot. Haradrim Palace is going to be quite helpful for the Haradrims. And at the very same time, we gotta build up more and more slaughterhouses inside the main castle to get the maximum food bonus. Remember, the building placement and also the building style or the chosen structure, if you want to say so, is extremely important in Battleform Middle-Earth 1 because every single building, resource building, is giving you some sort of bonuses. And for Mordor, it's important to build slaughterhouses. Why? Because it gives you the food bonus, making your monsters... That also counts on trolls, drummer trolls, and the Mumakils much, much cheaper. Okay, so what is the plan? We can also build an Orc Pit because the good thing about the evil faction is that if you lose units, in this case the Orcs, we will also get power points from losing them. So the more we spam, the more actually we will be able to get. Even though they might get one-shotted, but it's okay. It's not about killing something, but it's about creating pressure and forcing the opponent to play a bit more defensively. Oh, shoot! The Haradrims, they are so unreliable. Can you please shoot? Hey, run! Run! Run for it! Oh, the troll is punching and one-shotting us! That's so unfortunate! Dude, this troll is actually crazy. What? Can you please die, troll? Oh, he's gonna kill the Haradrim Palace too. Disengage Haradrims, not this direction. Run. Oh, one shot and four of them. This troll is a madman. And he's dealing so much damage to us. So before the Troll Cage, we can actually try to save up for a Nazgul or even the Witch King. Because again, we will get so much money from three Lamrim camps outside. Which is a lot of additional money with full slaughterhouses inside the castle. We need to try to get this troll out of the Haradrim Palace. Oh, the opponent might actually be creeping the troll here now in the middle. That would be a bad situation. I'm trying to lure the troll away by sacrificing my orcs. Just want to make sure that the troll is not able to fight us back by using the Haradrim and taking him finally down. There is a ruined tower. We could be placing those Haradrims inside the ruined tower, but I'm assuming my opponent was already able to garrison it. So, oh, Mel Gibson is actually looking to get... Okay, let's use Eye of Sauron to make him stronger. We can recruit now more Haradrims. We have almost 5,000 in the bank. It means we can get a very early Nazgul upon the field. Creeping, can we get it? Nah, he got the casted and he will also get the money. That's very, very unfortunate. Oh, that's painful to watch. And all of that because the troll was going mad on me, boys. Like, troll killed two of my Haradrims and one orc and dealt so much damage to me. And he's now buying the outpost too. Oh, that's like a really bad situation for me. Luckily, I have a Nazgul coming up very soon, so we should be in a kind of good spot. And my ally has actually heavy armor on the soldiers. Don't underestimate them, by the way, guys. They will also deal out... Oh, he's Aragorn already. What? I mean, I take it. Because we have nothing to deal damage to my Nazgul at this point. The problem is also the Nazgul is dealing almost no damage to Aragorn, right? Aragorn is a very tanky hero. He's the tankiest hero, actually, with Anduril and Blade Master combination. And he's also the strongest one in terms of melee damage. He can outpower everything. He can, like, three-shot Gandalf. And all of that for almost the half price of Gandalf. So Aragorn is very, very strong and super reliable. Especially with Anduril's Ward. So let's pick up the Tainted Land. Why? Because we will need later on the industry. And that's only pickable and choosable if you actually unlock the Tainted Land first. There's another Aragorn. They are both rushing Aragorns, man. And he will be able to take down my Tainted too. I mean, my Nazgul is doing a good job. But I think we need more than that. Okay, so... I mean, kill this Aragorn, man. My Gondor Knights from my ally, they can just take down this Aragorn. This Lamir camp is getting destroyed. Can we take down Aragorn, please? Come on now. Kill him, kill him. He used heal too. Oh, man. Okay, we need to defend this Lamir camp. We also... gonna get have a... We'll get the chance to recruit Witch King very soon. Oh, level 3. Defend, defend, defend. Repair, 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 repair. Can he do it? Can he do it? No, the last hit, you stupid peasant. Why would you do that? Okay, so we gotta repair the Citadel now. And there is Aragorn and... not Aragorn, but Theoden and Eowyn. Eowyn is the... Like, Theoden is the uncle of Eowyn, you know what I'm saying? Unfortunately. Because... I don't like Eowyn, to be honest with you. She can't cook. Alright, let's kill Eowyn now with the Nazgul because she has used the smite ability, right? There is also Aragorn. This Rohan is spamming heroes on us. We can also eventually take down Theoden, but the thing about Theoden is it's gonna reset the ability from Eowyn, so we gotta make sure to kill Eowyn first. You don't wanna kill Theoden because if Theoden dies close to Eowyn, she will be able to smite once again. Oh, Eowyn is gone. Now take down the Theoden. Oh, smart move from the player. Smart move. Did you see what he did? He was getting a hobbit out of the tower. This way he could place his Theoden in there. I mean, those Rohan, Rohirrim Archer Battalion, they can't do too much damage to me. There's a troll, but we can take him down. And now we have Witch King up on the field, so double trouble. There is nothing that can hurt our Nazgul anymore, or the Witch King rather. Witch King should be in a very good spot. He has no archers, and you know, we can always use Screech to take down off his archers, and our Faramir is doing a good job. So now we are in a kind of good spot, I would say. The armory will be taken down. Our ally has also leadership from our Witch King, so basically the Gondor Knights are dealing more damage now. Okay. Oh, the troll is going down, it's fine. There is Legolas also, right? Okay, we gotta be careful to not lose our Nazgul. Let's use I and bring Witch King closer. Now, this way, the Gondor Knights have 100% more DPS. And even though Aragorn made it to the Citadel, it doesn't really matter anything. Now we can get the third Nazgul up on the field. This Nazgul can heal up over time. And Aragorn has been taken down. It's perfect. Perfect, 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 for perfect. There is even Gimli up on the field, but what can Gimli do against such a reckless hit? Now, it's time, boys. It's time to build an army of Worthy of Mordor, and that's only possible with the movement kill action. So my ally is being under pressure, but we can send our Nazgul to defend him. In 4v4s, it's most of the time about teamplay, but we are not playing like a sportive Mordor faction as we are talking. We have now three flying heroes up on the field. We will get movement kills and we will start sieging the Rohan. Because I personally don't like to rely on my allies. I want to do stuff myself, you know? Double Orc Pit. I mean, to be honest, I believe in 4v4 matches, the most fun to play factions are Gondor and Rohan, because as Rohan especially, you get the chance to recruit multiple different heroes like Legolas, Aragorn, Gimli, Elwin, Elmer, Theoden. You have like 6-7 different heroes, and Mordor is kind of, you know, limited in terms of the strong potential to crush the enemy faction alone, right? Because Mordor is just like in team plays designed about being a supportive faction with, you know, which can kind of provide additionally lots of value with insane amount of leadership bonuses. But with the Moomer kills, we should be able to do stuff ourselves. Oh, Eowyn is here. Let's kill Eowyn. We have 3 Nazguls, 3 against 1. easy. Now let's crush Eowyn. Eowyn, the shield maiden of Rohan is no more. Can she use smite? No, she doesn't even use smite before going down. That's a perfect situation for us. 3 Nazguls, dude. Don't underestimate them, I'm telling you. Like, he's building now multiple towers, which is good, because the money could be invested elsewhere. The Gondor is camping because he can't do much against Mordor, as we are talking. We have now industry also. You can use it on the Gondor, by the way, to give him more money, because that's a new thing from the patch 2.22. Now you are able to use the buffs also on your allies, like Gondor and Rohan. It was not possible before. Recruits more orcs. You might be wondering, why would you waste command points on orcs? And you are right about it. But once again, it's good that we can create pressure. And as we are losing orcs, we are also gaining power points. But now we gotta make something stronger. And this is only possible with the trolls, Dremor trolls, and the Moomer kills. And what we're also gonna do is place those Haradrims on top of the Moomer kills, just like in the films. I mean, we are definitely in a very good spot. Aragorn has not even Anduril's Ward yet. We can always peel back to the Well of the Gondor or Rohan faction. Let's recapture the settlement. And yeah, we are in a good spot. I mean, money is looking good. Money is looking very, very good. We have our outpost. Now we will have to spam multiple Moomer kills. The way the Moomer kill pen works in Battle for Middle-earth 1 is, if the Moomer kill pen is level 3, every Moomer kill coming out of the Moomer kill pen is going to be level 2 automatically, which is good, because evil factions have no other way of sustain. I mean, we have definitely recovery possibilities in this situation, because it's a team game, but when you play a 1v1 situation, your monsters, if they are only level 1, they cannot heal up. Faramir, let's use the Tainted Land to cover this. Faramir is trying to show his quality, but he can't. Okay, we got a build. Actually, we are taking so much damage. Don't lose. Don't die, Nazgul. Screech, go back. And not even close, baby. Calculated. Now we can put them next to the well, and boom, we are good to go. The first Moomer kill is here. But I personally don't like to send only one Moomer kill. Hopefully we will be able to make like 5 to 8 Moomer kills. It will be actually quite awesome. The problem is that Rohan has many counters to that. Basically, Moomer kills are extremely vulnerable against fire. Imagine being good. Okay, we have so much money, but I don't know what to do with the money. I don't want to get catapults on the field, to be honest with you. This Mordor, what is this Mordor doing? I have Screech, my friend. Pew and flee, you fools. Run for your lives, as Denethor would like to say. Abandon your post. Did you guys like Denethor? By the way, guys, please let me know in the comment section down below if you want to see more 4v4 content on this channel. That's the very first time of the 4v4 gameplay. And if you guys enjoyed it, I can also try to get more games done. Because normally we cover always like 1v1s, 3v4s, and 2v2s. But 4v4, this one is going to be a unique video to the channel so far.
The enemy is on us!
More Moomer kills are required. The problem is going to be the command points, because if you don't know, the command points in Battle for Middle-earth 1 are scaling down. It means in a one-on-one fight, Mordor would have 500 available command points. But the more players are involved into the game, the less command points each player gets. And I believe the main reason for that is the engine, right? Basically, if everybody would have 500 command points available in a 4v4 match, it would mean like 4,000 worth of command points. And I believe the game would struggle to actually run smoothly without insane amount of lag or even crashing by containing and including this many units at the same time on the field. Maybe that's the main reason. Okay, so now let the siege begin, boys. Let the siege begin. The towers, they are coming up for Rohan, but the towers without fires, they don't deal too much damage to our Moomer kills. The breaking point is going to be the darkness spell from the spellbook. It's gonna make our units extremely strong, but he's cheating. You see, the Legolas is able to shoot over the wall because Mumakil is so big and the hitbox is so large. That's what she said. Oh, oh, oh! Legolas! Okay, we trampled one hero. I think it was Theoden. That's pretty good. That means he lost leadership. Let's trample them all. Mumakil can one-shot literally every single hero by just stepping on them. Eowyn, you will die for it. Eowyn is smiting Witch King and Mumakil is saying, hey, girl. I am no girl. I don't care. I'm a Mumakil, you know? Witch King got a deal. We gotta keep Witch King around, though, because we want to give additional damage and armor leadership to this Mumakil. Damage really doesn't matter much, but it's about the armor. And our Hradrims on top of the Mumakil are also doing a phenomenal job. Now we can bring more units. I think this attack won't achieve too much. Our Mumakils, once they have used the charge attack, will be extremely sloppy and slow. Oh, the Nazgul! No, I can't look. Is he gonna die? Yeah, he's dead. It's fine though, it's not the end of the world. We have still two more Nazguls. I wanna kill Legolas, but he's full HP. I don't think we can kill him. Look, our Mumakil is still dancing around the Rosie. Charge, charge, stupid Mumakil. Okay, another Nazgul has been taken down. And there comes the reinforcement from his Mordor ally. Oh, the Witch King is taking care of my... Oh, please, Witch King, don't die. I cannot afford to lose you. You are the most important and valuable hero of the Mordor. What is my ally doing? This guy is... We are like 1 hour in the game and he's making a peasant army. What a troll. What a troll are you, my friend? You are going to feed him with power points at this point. Okay, the next attack is going to be also empowered with the Trolls and Drummer Troll. Drummer Troll doesn't give leadership to Mumakil, but what it does is it gives leadership to the units on top of the Mumakil, right? So basically, our Hradrims on top of the Mumakil are going to deal this way much more damage. Okay, I want to actually go, but this Rohan is also an ally from the other Rohan, so they will turn now into a 2v1 situation against us. I'm sorry that I cannot show you what is going on elsewhere, because I'm like very, very tunnel vision focused on this Rohan. I want to finish him off as soon as I possibly can. And for the next attack, or during the next attack, we will also have the chance to unlock the darkness spell from the spellbook of Mordor for even more leadership. 33% more damage and also armor is going to make our Mumakils extremely beefy. Again, it's not about the damage, because Mumakils are almost able to one-shot everything they touch anyway. But it's about making them survive a bit longer, right? With Darkness, Witch King, and also the Eye of Sauron. Okay, 6 power points collected, Darkness. We can actually use it eventually. Also, my ally has Mumakils. They are sieging now the Mordor player. Again, there is no Isengard in this game, right? And without Isengard, there is no way they can shut down our leadership bonuses. Somebody is using the Cloudbreak, but it's fine. We can also use Eye of Sauron to make them even stronger. And we could also send a Drummer Troll there, but... I want to actually focus down now the other player, myself. Okay, the orcs are gone, that's good. Gandalf, don't die. Gandalf, don't die. The Mumakils are... Oh, the Witch King has been slain. Now we gotta bring our own Witch King, I believe. To support that. I see another darkness. I don't know from who this darkness actually is. I don't know. But I know that we are actually building an army worthy of Mordor now. Look how many Mumakils we have. Now the next attack is gonna be... Oh, hold on a second. This guy is shining bright like a diamond. Oh my goodness. Like his glorious charge. And Rangers, they are so weak against Trample. But he doesn't Trample too. I think that's a mistake from him. When he uses glorious charge, you wanna just charge them down. Even if you have Rohirrim archers, they can still Trample, right? Okay, now we gotta use this momentum, boys. Now we can go ham. You can also put Orc Archers with fire on top of the Mumakil, by the way. That's pretty good, actually, against Rohirrim Archers, because Rohirrim Archers are quite vulnerable against fire. Okay. So, that's gonna be fierce now, guys. He has nothing to defend himself, really. I mean, we can bring the Witch King here. We can break the part of the wall. There we go. Huge. And Eowyn was smiting our Drummer Troll. That's perfect situation for us, because now she has no more smite ability available. For the Witch King. Screech for the Elven warriors. Trolls are diving in too deep. And now we can bring in the big guns. You know, the big guns obviously are the Mumakils. And we see now more Rohirrim coming. More Rohirrim archer from the other Rohan player. Boom! Nice hit from the Witch King, the leader of the Nine. The leader of Minas Morgul. I see also Elven warriors upon the field. Legolas. So, it's gonna be tough now, I believe, to do... Oh, Aragorn! Oh my goodness, we wasted the charge attack, my bad. Hey, Legolas, what are you doing, my friend? You don't want to stand still there. Oh, Aragorn is actually protecting Legolas, but Legolas is getting knocked down. Kill him, kill him, kill him, kill him. Kill him, please. Use heal. Witch King, deal. Don't die, Witch King. I cannot afford to lose you, Witch King. Witch King is no more. Man. Our Nazgûs are going to be back on the menu very, very soon. We need more trolls up on the field. The problem is the command points, right? The movement kills, they are so expensive in the command points department. What is Aragorn doing? Okay, he's doing actually fine. In this 2v1 situation, dude, double Aragorn, double Legolas are actually painful to deal with. Two Eowyns, they can literally one-shot my Witch King from 100 to 0 with two smites. Oh, I see big fight here. We can use Industry once again on Gondor. I mean, again, money problems should not be a thing in 4v4 matches for anybody. Because in this game, you also get a lot of money. Maybe it's a waste of command points, to be honest, to put actually archers on top of the Momo kill. But let's do it anyway. And now we have two Nazgûs.
Hey, who's taking care of the Momo kill over there?
We have two Nazgûs. Okay. So there is Aragorn. They are trying to take down this outpost. But hey, guess what? I won't let this happen, my friend. I won't let this happen. I want to kill this Legolas. But I don't know if my Nazgûs can do that. Screech is not going to work on the level 5, but it's going to affect the level 2. Does he have heal, though? I'm going to trade a Nazgûl or two Nazgûs for Legolas. It's fine. I take it because I get so much more power points from it. Legolas gives you more power points from dying than Nazgûs do. And we were also able to keep the outpost from our ally protected. That's good. Let's get more Mumma kills. We have now 3 Mumma kills in total. But without Witch King, it's kind of meh, you know? We need to make sure to have Witch King back on the menu. Maybe we should be waiting now until the Witch King is back. Because I don't want to lose the Mumma kills. So the good thing is, once our Witch King is back on the menu, we will also have the Darkness ready. So we have Darkness plus Witch King that's as strong as Mordor can get. Imagine being a teammate. Let's get one more Nazgûl up on the field. There is Gimli. What is Gimli doing? Gimli, what are you doing there? Solo. Solo Gimli only here, boys. Okay, so we are command points capped. Now we can actually rotate. Darkness almost back up. We keep those Drummer Trolls next to the Mumma kills. This way they can have more leadership. The Haradrims on top of the Mumma kills. And let's see if Rohan can defend this. I mean, the problem is we have no Witch King and I'm scared. Because he has many, many Elven Warriors and Rohirrim Archers with this much leadership. I'm actually very afraid that they might burst me down. So, I think our ally that he can replace the Citadel. Witch King, how long you need? Oh, Witch King still needs a while, dude. I mean, I cannot afford to wait for Witch King at this point. I want to go, boys. I want to go. Okay, he's using Cloudbreak, but Cloudbreak doesn't negate Darkness. It only slows down our units and decreases their armor, but it's fine. Darkness is still stronger than Cloudbreak because the monsters cannot be stunned. You can only stun normal units when they are level 1 or level 2, unless they are fear resistant. So now, that's a mistake from him. And you are staying against 4 Mumma kills inside your castle. Watch this, guys. Please watch carefully now what's gonna happen. Unless he can burst us down fast enough. Watch this. Mumma kill. Okay, Eowyn. Hey, hey, Eowyn. He didn't do that. I'm going to. Let's go. We smashed him. Dude, we smashed everything. Legolas, what a timing. Legolas, Legolas, Legolas. Legolas is coming just as the dinner of this Mumma kills. Looks like meat's back on the menu, boys. Let's go. Let's go. All right. Oh, this is going to be GG now. I don't think this Rohan can be defended at this point of the game. I mean, he's killing Mumma kills. He has archers on top of the wall, but it's fine. He has even a Witch King or a Nazgûl. He's standing to defend his ally, but I think we are in a good spot. My ally is, in the meantime, just taking care of this tower. Just come inside and finish him off already, dude. We have 11 power points in the bank. One more trample is all it takes. And this Rohan is going to fall first. And against the power of Mordor, as Saruman the White would like to see, there can be no victory. I mean, this Rohan is camping, but that's going to be our... Oh, oh, is he coming? Is... Look, look. Hey, 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 hey. Watch this, guys. Please, watch this. It's a huge Rohan army, though. Charge, 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 charge. Yes, 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 yes. Oh, let's go. Dude, we killed everything, man. Holy guacamole. We destroyed him. Like the Mumma kill army. Let's go. Dude, we are only 4 power points away from the Balrog summon. That ladies and gentlemen, that's how a Mordor carry is looking like in 2022. And if you guys, hey guys, please make sure to leave a like on this video. Hopefully we can reach 300 likes. If we get 300 likes on this video, I will release faction guides for each faction, Rohan, Gondor, and Isengard and Mordor. So you can get a bit more, you know, knowledge about the build orders and also how to really play this faction specifically. We have done it already in the past, like a year or 2 years ago for the 1.06, but I want to make it a bit more in-depth, you know? This Rohan is camping, we can go for... I mean, look at our money, dude. We have over 20,000 in the bank. Money is no problem. We have now the second castle for the worst-case scenario. In the meantime, this Mordor is also falling into darkness. So it's going to turn the 4v4 situation into a 2v4 situation in favor of us, obviously.
What are you waiting for?
And yeah, let's go. Dude, okay, so my ally is also looking pretty strong. He has many, many Alvin units, but Valinorion has been defeated. In the meantime, you see, as we have defeated two of them, we get now more command points. So at the beginning, we had only 240, now we have 300. And again, the more we defeat, the more command points are going to be unlocked. Now we can get some siege wargs up on the field for the siege, because Rohan is going to be hard to defeat as he's camping. My ally Mordor has also plenty of trolls up on the field. We have now three castles to rule them all. Oh my goodness, my Moomer kills though. We see Entmoor also. I mean, this is gonna... By the way guys, did you know that the Drama Troll is also giving leadership to the Ents? So because Ents are classified as the Trolls, and Trolls are receiving leadership from the Drama Troll. So with the Drama Troll, you can also give leadership to the Ents and make them hit way, way harder. Which is pretty good. So, only 4 power points away from the Balrog, but I don't think he has much left on the field anymore for us to kill. And I believe that our ally has so much DPS now with the Elven units, Aragorn, Theorin, our Witch King and Drama Troll that won't give us the chance to kill anything. Everything he should be touching by now should be gone instantly. Alright, so we have 3 pieces, we have so much money. And... oh, he actually has a huge army, but you will see what's gonna happen to this army. Let's use Eye of Sauron. Let's cover this. He's using Glorious Charge, but that doesn't change anything. Because even... oh, my Drama Troll, please don't die. Oh. Oh, that's the... okay, that's the... okay, I was scared for a second. I was expecting this Rohan to use AOD, but it's actually the AOD from our ally. That's what it is. All right. Rest in peace, Rohan, I guess. You will lose now. We can siege him. Oh, the Moomer kills. No, that was exciting, guys. What do you think about the Moomer kill performance in this game? Guys, we killed so much. We killed Legolas and Aragorn and everything. This Rohan fortress is going down. Let's use darkness to make everything a bit stronger. And then the last player remaining is going to be... and that he got... yeah, he's gone now. The last player remaining... 2 Mordors better than 1. Unbalanced game. Yeah, dude. What is unbalanced? 2 Mordors is better than 1. Yes, sure. Of course. 2 Mordors are better than 1. Widowmaker is tilted. Alright, so this Rohan base is gonna fall into darkness, and that means we have only 1 more opening to defeat, and that's going to be the Gondor player, who is camping. Like, he has Stormwork, as you can see, the wall is shining bright like a diamond, and he has also plenty of ranges on top of the wall, but here is how you can deal with a camper in Battle for Middle-earth 1. So, oh, my ally is kinda underestimating the DPS from these arrow towers. He's underestimating. He has even tower guards in the porcupine formation right at the gate. My ally has triple siege works too, just why not? Let's now get... we cannot recruit more than 8 catapults. Okay, so we gotta be patient a bit. And again, in the worst case scenario, we will lose everything. But that will also be a good situation why we would be definitely able to get the 4 power points collected to summon the mighty Balrog. The Maia. The demon of the ancient world. Alright, so we can build towers. I don't know what to do with the money. I mean, we have full command points, right? I don't know what to do with the money, boys. Alright, let the siege begin. Let the siege begin. Oh, look at this Moomer kill army, dude. My ally has also Moomer kills. Many, many ranges upon the field. I see level 10 units left in rise. Now, my dear Gondor, the White City, is gonna be overrun. Because that's going to be a force of 4 players against only 1. You can use Cloudbreak all you want, that won't change anything. You know what I want to do? I want to actually send in the Nazgûls, but let's siege with the catapults or the eagles. That's a mistake from them. The eagles will get blown away. Luisi, they have no chance. They cannot survive for a single second. Hey, don't feed him too much. Don't feed him too much. Look at this Moma Kill army. Dude, I see 8 Moma Kills on my screen, like 10 trolls, 20 archers, catapults, elves. Like literally the full army of Battle for Middle-earth 1, and the only thing missing is Isengard. Okay, so does he have Gandalf too? Yeah, he has Gandalf, but what can Gandalf do against that? You know, as Pippin would like to see, but we have the White Wizard, it has to be good for something, but that's an exception to this rule. There is nothing Gandalf can do, because in the worst case scenario, we have also a Gandalf in our team. May the better Gandalf win. Now, to war, as Sauron would like to scream, let's go. Let's go now. I mean, we have so much leadership too. They can even tank those towers. Can you imagine? The trolls are charging. Darkness is available. The tower is getting lit. What is Boromir doing? He's like, for Gondor on top of the wall. But the wall is going to go down very soon. It's a strong wall, yes. But there is nothing that can be strong to face such a big force. Only EOD can kill that. The army of the red. But that's all about it. So, dude, my Moomba kill, I think in my Moomba kills this game, I killed like 20 heroes at bare minimum. And that was like the creme de la creme on top of the pie, as we have killed in the last moments of the game, the White Wizard Mithrandir. Gandalf the White is no more. And we need only 1.5 power points, but I'm assuming we won't be able to get to the point in which we can do that. We can get this. Our Nazgûls are dying, but I don't care, because the trolls and the Moomba kills are going to war. And we are sieging. I mean, my ally has even summoned Rohirrim. He doesn't move with them because he doesn't have to. Look at this screen, boys. Look at this fiesta. Look at this. First 4v4 gameplay on this channel. Again, if you enjoyed this game, please make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more like this in the future. I will see you next time, hopefully. Until then, take care of yourselves. And as always, guys, keep hitting like a truck. And also, stay beyond standards. Peace out. The great sea.